Welcome, all friends of the Dhamma. Mindfulness immersed throughout the whole body. That means mindful, be conscious, knowing yourself and seeing yourself. Mindful, knowing yourself, seeing yourself. This is very important. Mindfulness regarding the body will be the power for you to go deep, okay? Just now, I just doing things and I just see myself, watch myself, observe myself, and it's calm, okay? It's calm. So this is the first foundation. You must make the foundation big if you want to go deeper, okay? Foundation on the body. Just sensing yourself. Sensing, 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 sensing. And now, can you just sit and watch the whole sitting? Watch. Watch and see. Watch and see. Watch and see until thought finish. Watch and see until you don't go out, think about any other thing outside. Watch and see until you go inside and thought calm down and finish. Watch and see. And now, when you watch and see, you can start from the full posture, the posture of sitting now. Can you watch and see the posture of sitting? And you just stay on this step until you get calmness naturally and not long. Watch and see. Watch and see this sitting posture, what you see more, what you see more than the sitting. You can see the movement of the body because you're still alive, okay? But watch and see with the mind not move, but you can see the body movement. Body got pulse, body got breathing, so it make your body movement. Watch and see, and then what you see more? You can see body and your mind become calm. You can see the calmness of mind. Watch and see. And watch and see what you see more. You can see sometimes more calmness, sometimes a bit thought come. Sometimes big thought come, then less calmness. But when you see, continue seeing, thought become less. And then you get more and more calmness. Watch and see. Watch and see. Watch and see from the whole body. Not up, not right, not left. From the whole. By relax your body. When you relax your body, you feel fully conscious more and more. And keep conscious. Can you keep conscious? Keep conscious over the whole body. When you keep conscious, it becomes more consciousness. Fully conscious. And seeing by full consciousness. See now, you got breathing, got rising, falling. Got movement. Watch and see, like your consciousness become one with the body. Okay, become one with the body. Don't have to lift up your mindfulness to watch over. Okay, just knowing here, watch here, feeling here, watch here. Okay, keep consciousness over the body. And then, even I talk to you, my consciousness see the body movement. This vipassana, because you not expect anything. You just start from the four posture, sitting posture, walking posture, standing posture, even sleeping posture. Tonight, you just keep consciousness and see, keep consciousness and seeing. Before you try to watch and see, but you keep consciousness and see, okay? Then your consciousness not lost in thought, okay? Not too much wake up, okay? Just keep conscious over the body. Now keep consciousness, even you sit relaxed, even you talk to people. This view make you got more wisdom about how much more you have to come to rebirth. When you keep consciousness, then your consciousness not go to your eye, become pressure or unpressure. Not go to your ear, become pressure or unpressure. Your consciousness is your soul, okay? Now you know you got body, mind, and soul, okay? Okay, mind and soul, okay? Body, mind, but this mind, after got more calmness, then it go become one to the pure mind, and then the pure mind wake up, okay? So you can see that now when the pure mind wake up, it bring your soul wake up. So that's why in Christian, they told me, come to see your spirit and soul. Spirit wake up, okay? And with soul, okay? In this state is calmness meditation. After you wake up with spirit and soul, okay? Then you just turn inwards. Keep conscious. Keep conscious sensing yourself. Now come to Buddhist meditation or vipassana. Keep consciousness. Keep conscious. Seeing the body. When you see the body with consciousness, you can see your mind or your heart or your feeling. Okay? Just keep conscious. Normally, you always put stillness to put concentration, put attention, but now keep attention, keep consciousness. Okay? Keep, okay? Not sitting out. Keep attention on yourself, what you are doing. Keep consciousness, knowing and seeing how you're doing. Keep consciousness. When you keep consciousness, okay, your consciousness pure and purer and become higher consciousness. Now it become more higher consciousness. It's bright, got blindness. Okay? It got blindness. And then your consciousness, you keep consciousness, even it got blindness, it's not turned out. It still turned inwards. Okay? Okay. It's different from you practice jaga meditation. And then you turn out. Okay? Turn out. This to develop energy or power. But anyhow, you can turn inwards. When you wake up with the jaga meditation, you can turn into Buddhist meditation by turning inwards. Okay? Turning inwards is look like you sit in the calmness. Okay? Sit in the calmness. And when you sit in the calmness become I, seeing yourself, seeing the body, the feeling, the mind quality, okay? Then you just sit in the calmness and contemplate yourself, okay? So on the practice, you must have this foundation. Normally you practice breathing meditation. You put your attention here, and then you stay here with the knower. Okay? But if you have this mindfulness regarding the whole body, immerse the whole body until it becomes Zen, it looks like you go up and see this body keep attention on the breathing in and out. And this become eye of Dhamma. See what the body doing. And can see the body keep attention on the breathing. And this can see both. Can see both the object of knowing and can see the knower or the one who watch. Okay? Normally I tell you, come to the one who watch. Okay? You stay here. This is develop right concentration from inside. Still samatha or calmness meditation. But after that, you know how to wake up your soul or consciousness. Then you have more, another field. Seeing this field is put attention on the breathing, and this field got duality, object and knower. Okay, got duality. Then you can see all this world got duality. This is duality world. Okay, duality world. Then when you see this truth, then it let go all clinging or attachment to duality in this world. It just become wisdom, seeing things as they are. Okay? This person not doing anything, just sitting. Or this person breathing in, breathing out, and how this person do, doing with selfness or non-self, okay? Then normally you put non-self and to focus. Then you put selfness to focus. Then your mind go out. But now I teach you just go up and see this person. Not you who focus, but see this person who is doing something. Then this person will do meditation with non-self meditation. Okay? So now, can you see this person in daily life? This person always happy, unhappy, okay? Joyful or angry. Or you can see when you have quarrel with your wife or husband. If you got this consciousness wake up, you can see this person now angry and try to hit something. But after you seeing, you cannot hit because you see with wisdom, the anger come, and now you are now you lose consciousness. But when you see, you got more consciousness. Okay, you cannot. Not you may be a bit angry, but not more anger to throw something, to hit something, okay? Because you got wisdom. So now if you got wisdom, consciousness seeing this person, okay? Not this person only want this, okay, this person angry or joyful, but when you see this person, joy come, not lost in joy. Anger come, not lost in anger. Okay? So now, you first step, you develop meditation by body and mind. Observe, watch and observe the body. That is the breathing. But now today, we will got soul wake up. Consciousness, seeing body and mind, okay? Seeing body and mind. So that's why this is advanced level, okay? Body now sitting, but you not see this body, you immediately focus on the breathing. But if you stay with consciousness, seeing the body, that means I give you technique, just remind yourself what this person doing. When you remind yourself, remind, consciousness more wake up. Remind yourself what this person doing. Then you can see with consciousness, the higher consciousness. This is your soul, okay? Or let's say your spirit and soul, okay? It depends on what concept you mean for the spirit and soul, okay? Or let's say consciousness, higher consciousness. This is higher consciousness. Can see, don't have to watch. Can see, okay? This person now sitting and relax and breathing, okay? And how this person feel, how this person think. No, not thinking and lost. Now thinking mindfully, okay? So now you can stay with your spirit and soul or higher consciousness. Higher consciousness can see now this person got body. This person got mind. Mind as thought or mind as feeling. And now this higher consciousness sitting with you when you're sitting. Walking with you or know you're walking. Sitting and you know you're sitting. Okay? When you know you're sitting, fully conscious, then it become clear as a mirror. Like a mirror with good exposure. Okay? Seeing this person. So if you can stay on this state, seeing this person the whole day, then you free from all dependent origination. You just see the nature of dependent origination, okay? And you can free yourself more and more till you go to enlightenment. If you stay on this test the whole day, like we can say like the inner body sleeping inside, now inner body wake up. The astral body sleeping inside, now astral body wake up. Okay? Yeah. And this person before sitting, the inner body sleeping. But this person sitting, the inner body wake up. Okay? But in Buddhist tradition, we not use the word inner body. We use the word body consciousness, okay? Because we will develop more by contemplating the body. But if you attach to the inner body, then you not develop more, okay? So this is only the result of the calmness, the inner body wake up. But we not attach to word, to concept. We just develop more wisdom with this consciousness, seeing all activity this body doing the whole day, okay? Then consciousness become wisdom. But if you just attach to the inner body, then it look like you got development of the power of mind only. But still okay. This level, okay? Very powerful, okay? But to develop wisdom, we go beyond the inner body. We just interpret them into abstract, not self, okay? Abstract, that means consciousness, okay? When we interpret them into abstract as consciousness, then we just be mindful, seeing, be conscious, knowing and seeing. Then this become wisdom eye, the light of wisdom. No inner body. Now inner body disappear. Only the light of wisdom. So this is Arahant. Okay? Inner body, in Arahant, how you know? My master say he can see what who attain Arahant already. My master can see inside no inner body. Inner body no more. It become wisdom. Okay? But if still got inner body, you still maybe layman or Sodaban, Sakitakami, Anakami, still got inner body. Okay? Arahant, inner body turn to wisdom already. No more rebirth. Okay? With inner body, you still have to come to rebirth. Or maybe you go to the realm of Brahma, for eon, long time. But after that, you have to come to rebirth again, because you still got inner body, okay? So if you just develop this wake up, we call consciousness. We use the word differently. Consciousness, so then we not attached to the inner body, okay? Consciousness, then we need to develop consciousness more and more to become wisdom, then no inner body, okay? Okay, so that is my master, even himself, he still got inner body because he still go up to the anakami in the Suttavat, Brahma Suttavat, but he become non-returner. He will enlightenment at the Suttavat, Brahma Suttavat, okay? So Brahma Suttavat, then he got enlightened, become Arahant, not non-returner. Anakami will go living in the Suttavat from. Okay? Suttavat from only, okay? If not Suttavat from, maybe long time and then come to rebirth again, okay? So now, just really simple, just fully conscious, knowing, seeing, not knowing, seeing very far, knowing, seeing very near, okay? Can you know and see near to your body? It look like there are two layers. This body and the other layer is the consciousness. Okay? Can you stay a bit from the physical body, a bit, okay? So that's why one of my master say, in Thai language, jit yu neu kham kit, jit laka chai yu neu arom. You near how much? You near 1 min pho la. This master told me how to over only 1 millimeter. Here. No need to expand over here. We call jit you near kwam kit jai you near arom. So you have two layer. Okay? This is the way to enlightenment, okay? Okay. But if you consciousness, you can develop consciousness to become power, then it become enlarged, okay? You can develop this consciousness with power, enlarged as big as the world, enlarged as big as the universe. But enlightenment enough. Just stay over the body consciousness enough. Now you can rely now, even you're not practice meditation, you just listen to my talk, you still can keep conscious, knowing and seeing. It look like you have the other overcoat. You have overcoat, one more overcoat, okay? Knowing and seeing, okay? And you feel warm and safe, okay? Feel warm and safe. Even you close your eye, close this eye, but open this eye. You can try. doing nothing, not do anything, just like you wake up with fully consciousness immersed throughout the whole body and sensing yourself sitting. all in the knowing of full consciousness, all in the knowing. It looks like you don't have to do anything. Just be conscious, knowing yourself, seeing yourself, all in the knowing. Or even use it some detto method. Be conscious knowing. Be conscious seeing yourself. From higher consciousness. Just put your two hands over your chest and just doing nothing. And be conscious. From the moment, it's easy to develop consciousness. Be mindful knowing how the body movement and be conscious knowing how sitting, how the body sitting and smile, then be conscious inside how smile and be conscious both inside and outside, fully conscious throughout the whole body. Throughout the whole body. now you got mindfulness immersed throughout the whole body. Fully conscious, knowing and seeing by consciousness. And now, before we finish this session, just reveal how much calmness you got, how much mindfulness you got. And then just keep your hand open on your knee and just transfer it to everybody at home, your dad, your mom, your son, your daughter, and to anybody at your workplace, to your friend and enemy, and to your karma, and also an angels here, and to all being. Let them feel much more happiness and much more happiness. And then bring merry to yourself for good luck, good life, happiness, and all success. Now we finish this session. Thank you. This we call Kayagatasati. Okay? Kayagatasati. Seeing. Mm-hmm.